So the other day you guys seen me make some adjustments to my 120 gallon uaru amphicanthoids aquarium. Essentially, I just removed all the manzanita that was in it, creating more space for the uaru to have a bit of a growth spurt and grow a little bit larger. You see, once that was removed, I added in these freestanding logs. You guys seen this in the past video. I had mentioned also that I wanted to do a species profile on the uaru. And to be honest with you, I was about to sit down and do that species profile when I realized how much I didn't like this aquarium. I know many of you guys probably said you liked it, but were secretly thinking, I'm glad it's your tank and not mine. I decided I needed to make a change, make this look a little bit more natural, and kind of stand out from the discus aquarium. So what I decided I would do is do this on a budget. And I wanted to kind of show you guys what I did because I think this might help many of you guys create a more naturalistic aquarium for like, I don't know, $5. You guys have seen this idea in the past. I take catalpa leaves or Indian almond leaves and I add them to the aquarium. I remembered I had a bunch in my basement. In fact, I've got hundreds of these leaves because I got tons of tanks that I thought I was going to be adding them to. I discovered them when looking for some sponge, grabbed a couple packets of them, some bigger sizes and some larger sizes, boiled them just to remove some of the tannins and to make them sink immediately, because if you don't do that, they might float for a couple of days. Then dump them into the aquarium. I rearranged the logs as well, taking a couple out because I knew that once I added in some stones and these leaves, I'm gonna want it to be a little bit more open space for the uaru. Of course, adding in just the leaves looked pretty cool, but you do want it to look a little bit more aged. So I added in the substrate over top of it, kind of mixing it on top, and then added in some river stone. Which types of stone you're gonna wanna use is completely up to you, but I've shown you guys how to collect these types of stones from the wild, from washing them, sanitizing them, and making sure they're safe for your aquariums as well. I already had these, so I added in some just randomly throughout the tank. I had no plans on where they were gonna be placed or anything of the sort. I do find I get a more natural look if I just randomly place them with, of course, the larger stones towards the rear of the aquarium. From there, cover them in a little bit with some more substrate, making it look a little bit more aged. Now, if you're not as familiar with what catalpa leaves are or what Indian almond leaves are, essentially these are a leaf that many use to create a more naturalistic aquarium as they release tannins in the water and also release a humic acid, which of course can lower your pH. Those are not properties I'm looking at, but they also are said to have some antibacterial properties. For me, when it comes to using catalpa leaves or Indian almond leaves, I enjoy just the way it looks like leaf litter on the ground. I do like to use a couple of different sizes because that to me looks a little bit more natural. And of course, the releasing of the tannins gives it a bit of a black water effect, which is in turn where the uaru are often found in tannin-filled waters. Now, when it comes to purchasing the Indian almond leaves or catalpa leaves, you can get them on Amazon, eBay. They're all over the internet at this point. You can expect to pay about, I don't know, $5 to $10 for up to 100 leaves. I got these, which is about 100 of them. I think I got these on Amazon or eBay for $10. I will have to replace them depending on how often and how crisp I want them to look, upwards of or as little as 1 week into it or as much as 2 to 3 months, because they will slowly start to disintegrate over time. But your fish and some will actually eat a little bit of it as well. Now, since I did just add this to the aquariums and I was kind of making a bit of a mess, the uaru are currently hiding, but they will come out and enjoy this scape a little bit more. But I am dying to see what you guys think. Something so simple changed the entire dynamic of this aquarium for like $5. I might have added 20 big leaves and some little ones, and they cost me maybe $5 or less, to be honest with you, probably a lot less. But I wanted this video to serve as a simple idea that you can do for very little money to change the entire dynamic of your aquarium. My suggestions would be to perhaps start with the smaller leaves and use this on smaller aquariums. It works great for bettas, lots of tetras, some of the smaller epistogramma, and even some of the smaller cichlids, and the list goes on. It's great for those smaller fish and creating that black water effect. A bonus tip would be to use twigs on the ground as well. I do find that adds an even bit greater dynamic to the aquarium, making it even look more natural. But we went from a simple substrate to something like this, and even though it's like messy and perhaps even ugly to some, it's certainly far more natural than what it was previously. And of course, over the course of the next couple of weeks or so, I'll probably make some adjustments. But I think one of the keys to making this look a little more settled was, of course, disturbing the substrate and bury them in the rocks a little bit. So again, just a quick video on how you can kind of make your aquariums look a little more natural. I know we've covered this months ago, but never really made it a feature video. However, I think many people can benefit from this that are kind of struggling to make their aquariums look a little more natural or maybe a little more unique for very little money and very little effort. As you can see, I just kind of dropped the rocks in, and I think the end result is quite nice. So I'm much more satisfied with this aquarium, and of course I'd love to move into that uaru species profile. Of course, that is one of my all-time favorite fish, and the name of my channel's URL, Uaru Joey, and I'd love to tell you guys a lot more about them. So if you're excited to see that, you're not subscribed to this channel yet, you want to see that, make sure that you do. One more thing, this entire video, we have not been alone. So if you guys don't know, I also have a thing called Members Only. I basically a team membership where for a few bucks a month, you can get behind the scenes. You can, we do exclusive live streams, but right now these guys have been watching the whole thing with, as we've been filming it, just giving them a little bit of behind the scenes. So if that's something you guys are interested in being a part of, click the join button, or there will be a link in the description below. They're all trying to get shown, so maybe we'll show you guys them. Calm down.
I feel like something sticky's on here. There it is. I think, what do I do out here?
Make this look a little bit more natural and kind of stand out from the Discus Aquarium.
How am I doing?
So what I decided I would do is do this on a budget, and I wanted to kind of show you guys